As the scientists stepped out of the safety of their research base into the frozen Antarctic air, they couldn't believe what they saw. It chilled them to their very core. The normally white landscape was covered with crimson streaks and patches that stretched out into the horizon. It looked like blood. In today's episode of the Infographic Show, we'll take a look at the spooky blood snow that's taking over an Antarctic island. In February 2020, the researchers at the Vernadsky Research Base, a Ukrainian Antarctic research station, noticed some strange changes to the snow. A seemingly inexplicable red stain was splattered all over the area. This led to some of the researchers giving the unusual phenomena the nickname raspberry snow. Although much like lemonade snow, we're willing to bet it probably didn't taste all that good. On the frosty plains of Galindez Island, red puddles had formed. It looked like the site of a bloody massacre, but it couldn't really be blood, right? Before we answer that, let's look at another unnerving question. Has this ever happened before? Well, yes. All the way back in the 3rd century, even the ancient Greek philosopher Aristotle mentioned witnessing blood-colored snow. So it's not exactly a new thing. In fact, Galindez Island isn't the only place where blood appears to have been spilled onto the snow. Even within Antarctica, there's another example, the aptly named Blood Falls, a huge stream of red liquid that's been pouring from the Taylor Glacier and spilling out into the McMurdo dry valleys of East Antarctica. From miles around, anyone can see the snow being turned crimson as the blood-like water that flows into Lake Bonnie, almost like an ancient wound torn open. But Antarctica isn't alone. In 2007, Lago Ramelo in Iraq turned blood red, causing online sleuths to go wild with conspiracy theories. Some thought criminals had been dumping bodies or parts of bodies into the water, enough to contaminate it with the victim's blood. In Iran, NASA satellites also caught Lake Urmia changing from its more natural green hue to a terrifying red. So what exactly is going on here? Rivers or lakes of blood? Biblical plagues? Well, in the cases of Iraq's Lago Ramelo and Iran's Lake Urmia, the explanation is more scientific than sacrificial. You see, Lake Urmia has a high concentration of salt, and when combined with the warmer temperatures in the water, this provides the perfect breeding conditions for Halobacteriaceae. These microscopic bacteria have a distinctive red pigment and can turn the water red. This has never been confirmed to be the cause of the blood lake over in Iraq, though. Unverified claims suggest that local slaughterhouses have been dumping bloody animal carcasses into the lake. Some have also suggested that raw sewage is being diverted into the lake and that the red coloration is the result of the water treatment process. Okay, so at least that partly clears up those two, but what about the bloody sites over in Antarctica? Well, scientists have been aware of the cause of the red liquid pouring down the blood falls for some time, and it's not caused by bacteria. Instead, it's caused by ancient water trapped underneath the Taylor Glacier. This water was extremely salty, and now that the glacier is gradually melting, this ancient salt water has been gradually trickling out. When it's exposed to oxygen, it turns a rusty reddish hue, making the ice look like the back of Jules Winfield's car in Pulp Fiction. In a way, it's a foreboding visual metaphor for the deadly consequences of the shrinking ice caps and glaciers thanks to global warming. Back to the northern Antarctic Peninsula on Galindez Island, the Ukrainian scientists quickly realized what this raspberry snow was. It wasn't blood at all, it wasn't even ancient salt water. Instead, it was the work of something so small that you probably wouldn't even know it if it was right under your nose. Algae. The red-tinted Chlamydomonas nivalis thrives in the colder climates in the snowfields and mountains of Antarctica, lying dormant until the summer starts to melt the snow. Then the algae starts to bloom and spread spores that are, you guessed it, also red in color. It's the same pigment, known as carotenoids, that give carrots and pumpkins their distinctive orange coloration. These carotenoids are located in the chloroplasts of the algae and absorb just enough heat to keep the algae alive, but also keep them protected from the sun's ultraviolet light. But while that might just be what the algae needs, it is really bad for the snow. Beyond just making everything look like the bloodied set of an Antarctic slasher movie, the blood snow absorbs more sunlight and the snow melts faster, and that contributes directly to climate change. It's become a vicious cycle. With hotter summers in Antarctica, the algae is able to produce more spores. They spread across the snow, making it melt, leading to more warming, more algae spreading, and on it goes. So the more the climate changes, the more you can expect to hear stories about what looks like blood-stained snow. A sight that, unless more is done to curb the effects of climate change, might actually be a grim omen of the end of times. Now check out insane conspiracy theories that turned out to be true, or watch this video instead.